This workflow video highlights and expands upon your existing protocol. To get the most out of this tutorial, have your protocol at hand. This workflow can be summarized in the following diagram. First, sample preparation using the PrepMan Ultra sample preparation reagent. Then, assay setup with the MicroSEQ PCR reagents. Sequencing using the Applied Biosystems 3500 DNA sequencing instrument. And analyze results with the MicroSEQ ID microbial identification software. This section will focus on the preparation and extraction of samples for bacterial and fungal testing. To prepare bacteria or fungi from a culture plate, dispense the appropriate quantity of PrepMan Ultra sample preparation reagent into your sample tubes. To prevent contamination, do not pipette directly out of the PrepMan Ultra sample preparation reagent bottle into the sample tubes. Select an isolated colony and obtain a small loop full of cells or the edge of a filamentous fungus colony on a culture plate. It is key to start from a single, isolated colony of around 2 millimeters diameter, since too much input material or mixed colony material can cause errors. In case of problems with sample prep for fungi, for example, no DNA extracted or too much DNA extracted, consider using a broth culture. Centrifuge to pellet the cells and use PrepMan Ultra to lyse the pellet. Resuspend the cells in the PrepMan Ultra sample preparation reagent, vortex, and place in a heat block set to 95 to 100 degrees Celsius. Remove the sample tubes from the heat block. Cool and centrifuge to collect pellets. Then transfer 15 microliters of the supernatants to a new set of tubes. Combine 495 microliters of nuclease-free water with 5 microliters of the PrepMan reagent supernatant. The remaining supernatant can be stored at 4 degrees for 1 month or frozen at minus 20 degrees. Throughout this protocol, ensure all the liquid in the plate wells is collected at the bottom of the wells before proceeding to the next step. Look for these points with a note, centrifuge. The next step is setting up the real-time PCR assay. First, prepare the reaction mixture. For fungal identification, in a single tube, combine the primer mix and PCR mix. For bacterial identification, the Fast PCR Master Mix already contains the primers, so you can proceed directly to setting up PCR reactions. Vortex briefly, then centrifuge to collect all liquid at the bottom of the tube. Vortex the diluted supernatant to mix the tube contents. Using the volumes shown in your protocol, prepare samples and controls in the microamp reaction tubes or 96 well plates. Use strip caps and the capping tool or adhesive film and the sealing tool to cap the tubes or plate. Vortex, spin briefly, then place the tubes or the plate in the thermal cycler. Set the appropriate ramp mode for your thermal cycler. Set the correct thermal cycling conditions as shown in your protocol. Set the reaction volume to 30 microliters, then start the run. After the run, centrifuge to collect liquid. Remove unused DNTPs and primers from each PCR product using either ExoSapit USB or Montage PCR filter unit Millipore. Following DNTP removal, centrifuge to collect liquid. Use caution in pipetting ExoSapit of very small volumes. In case of difficulty extracting DNA from fungal cultures, especially Aspergillus brasiliensis, consider the use of broth culture. Spin 1 milliliter of sample. Aspirate and discard the supernatant, and use PrepMan Ultra sample preparation reagent directly on this pellet. At this step, and at the end of each section throughout this protocol, you may cover and store the unused product at 4 degrees overnight or at minus 20 degrees for up to 1 week. Look for these points with the note, stop and store. The next step of the protocol is setting up the sequencing reaction. In reaction tubes or a 96 well plate, prepare separate forward and reverse sequencing reactions for each PCR product and control as demonstrated here. cap the tubes or the plate. Then place the tubes or the plate in the thermal cycler. Set the appropriate ramp mode for your thermal cycler. Set the thermal cycling conditions. Set the reaction volume to 20 microliters. Then start the run. At this point, you can centrifuge, stop, and store your reaction. Remove excess dye terminators and primers from the cycle sequencing reaction using Edge Bio Performa cleanup kits. If the electrophoresis runtime will be longer than 24 hours, for example, if you are injecting more than 40 wells on a 4-capillary instrument, evaporation may occur. Therefore, Life Technologies recommends the addition of formamide to the reactions. See protocol for further information. Configure the instrument with the parameter settings shown in your protocol. Pipette at least 15 microliters of each purified extension product or control into separate wells in a 96-well plate. Pipette 15 microliters of high-dye formamide into each blank well that will be injected together with samples. Cover the plate, centrifuge, and at this point, you can stop and store your reaction or load your plate and start your run. The final step of the protocol is to analyze the results. When using MicroSEQ identification software, no species ID may result if the species is missing from the product library. MicroSEQ ID product libraries are constantly updated, but you can also create and validate your own custom libraries. A low percentage match may be obtained with MicroSEQ ID if the species is not in the MicroSEQ ID library. BLAST may be used as an additional source of reference. The MicroSEQ ID system enables you to assess the quality of raw data, specimen score, which gives additional confidence to the ID result. No other system takes into account the quality of the raw data when assessing ID results. If there is no sequence or primer sequence only, too little colony could have been taken. For additional tips and tricks, refer to your protocol. For more information, as well as detailed protocols, visit lifetechnologies.com/MicroSEQ.